2017 has been all about bezel-less smartphones. A trend which started with LG's G6 flagship back in February is now the USP of most major flagship launches. So much so that even Apple and Google couldn't resist going bezel-free, and the upcoming Apple iPhone X as well as the Google Pixel 2 XL sport very sleek bezels. Well, the good news is that this feature is no longer limited to the high-end. Meet the Vivo V7 Plus, an affordable smartphone which comes with a bezel-less design, and in this review, I'll be telling you if this is a good buy or not. Let's kick things off by talking about the smartphone's USP, which is its display. So with the screen turned off, the Vivo V7 Plus might look like an ordinary smartphone. However, switch on the display and voila, you get what is essentially a 6-inch screen packed inside the body of a 5.5-inch phone. Now, there's two advantages of going bezel-free. Firstly, you get a lot more screen without increasing the overall dimensions of the phone, and secondly, you get a more immersive media consumption experience. Now, Vivo nails the first aspect, but the second is more of a miss in my opinion. You see, while you won't be intruded by the thick bezels on the top and the bottom of the smartphone while watching a movie, you will have to deal with the low resolution HD Plus panel. Therefore, watching movies in full HD is a no-go on the V7 Plus. That said, the V7 Plus does get sufficiently bright and you will have no problems using the smartphone under broad daylight. So guys, now let me tell you about the rest of the smartphone's design. So the V7 Plus has been constructed out of a unibody plastic design, which is slightly disappointing since you expect a smartphone priced around Rs 20,000 to be constructed either out of metal or some other premium material. With that said, I would like to say that the V7 Plus looks good in person, and the use of plastic helps keeping the weight of the smartphone down as well, so you won't have to carry a heavy lump of metal in your pockets. Okay guys, now let's talk about the V7 Plus's performance. So, the V7 Plus is powered by a Snapdragon 450 processor which works with 4GB of RAM and 64GB of expandable storage. Now, the Snapdragon 450 processor was recently unveiled by Qualcomm, and it's a slightly slower processor than the Snapdragon 625 chip which we have seen on smartphones like the Xiaomi Mi A1, the Xiaomi Redmi Note 4 as well as the Moto G5 S Plus. Now, bear in mind that all of these smartphones are cheaper than the V7 Plus, and therefore, I feel that Vivo should have at least equipped the smartphone with an equivalent chip or priced it slightly lower. Having said that, the device managed to run fairly smooth in my usage, and unless you're doing some intensive gaming, the smartphone won't slow you down. My only gripe is that in the longer run, a faster processor would have helped the smartphone age better. Speaking of performance, the Vivo V7 Plus comes with a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor which works great. The fingerprint sensor has been positioned really well and it is extremely snappy. Good selfies are part of the package when you buy a smartphone from Vivo, and the same is true for the Vivo V7 Plus as well. The smartphone is backed by a 24-megapixel selfie shooter which clicks some incredibly detailed photos. In fact, it is a little too good at clicking portraits, as it shows even the smallest blemishes on your face. The front camera is backed by a selfie flash too, and therefore, you won't have to find a well-lit spot to click a good selfie at night. The 16MP rear camera of the smartphone isn't too shabby either, and is capable of clicking some really nice pictures. As you can see from some of the sample shots I've attached in the video, the camera managed to capture a good amount of detail in broad daylight. The color reproduction is good too, and the smartphone manages to blur the background in macro shots really well. Low light performance isn't the best, and pictures are often filled with considerable noise and grain, but that's the case with most smartphones in this price segment. If this isn't your first rodeo with a Chinese smartphone, then you know what to expect software-wise. Much like most other Chinese OEMs, you'll get a heavily themed skin on the V7 Plus, which lays all of your apps on the home screen itself. The software and the menus bear an uncanny resemblance to iOS, and even come with some of Apple's trademark features like pulling up from the bottom to bring up the notification center and so on. So the Vivo V7 Plus is backed by a 3225mAh battery, which coupled with the smartphone's HD Plus display lasts for a good amount of time. So over the course of my review period, I had no problems hitting the 4 or 4.5 hour screen on time mark with the V7 Plus, and the smartphone managed to last me through some really long days. So should you buy the Vivo V7 Plus? Well, the answer isn't as simple as a yes or a no. You see, the smartphone can certainly click some incredibly detailed selfies, and it does come with a bezel-less design too, but I feel that it misses more than it hits. For its asking price of Rs 21,990, the display quality isn't very good, and the performance is average at best as well. Had the smartphone been priced lower at around rupees 17,000, then it could have been a good buy, but for now, I feel that you can get much better value for your money elsewhere. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this Vivo V7 Plus review. If you did, give it a thumbs up and make sure to share it with your friends. This is Prateek from 91 Mobile signing off. Take care.